Hello there, this is Lotte Brouwer, and now you are watching Violin Lounge TV, where you learn to improve your violin and viola playing with joy. And let me ask you a question. Do you know how and when to maintain your instrument? I see a lot of violinists and violists with instruments or bows that really need some maintenance. And it affects also your playing and your intonation and your tone. So it's quite important to have that covered, because it would be strange if you take so much time and effort and money to learn to play, and then you're playing on something that is not ready to play or not playable. So, well, let me share you some tips what you need to do, and a schedule for you to maintain your instrument, keep it beautiful, keep it playable, and so forth. Well, I've got two tips for every day, and that is to relax or untighten your bow every time you don't play. Even if you take just a little break, then just untighten your bow. I will show you how much. Because a lot of violinists have their bow tightened like this. They think their bow must be straight. But a bow isn't called a bow for nothing, because it has the shape of a bow. There is a bow shape in it. So if you tighten your bow, just turn the screw to the right. And then you must have here, between the wood and the hair, you must have more distance than here in the middle. In the middle, you should be able to put a pencil between the bow and the hair, just so, not much more. And at the tip, the hair is again a little more from the bow. So the shape of the bow is like this, and it's not straight. If you stop playing, even if you're just taking a little break, because I want you to make it really a routine, because maybe you take a break and then you forget that you were playing, you go do something different, and then your bow stays tightened. So just turn the screw to the left, and then you really must turn until the hair touches your bow, that the hairs are, you know, really loose. You can't do it really very, very wrong. Okay, so make that do that automatically when you put away your bow. Certainly if you put it away in the case, then it should never be tightened, because then you really, your bow can be thrown away if it's completely out of shape. Well, every day you can, to maintain your strings and also to maintain the polish of your violin, you just take a dry microfiber cloth and you just wipe over over the soundboard. So you put the cloth into here. You wipe over all the string like this, so the rosin gets off your string. That's better for your strings, because if the rosin stays on your soundboard and on your strings, it becomes very sticky and you can't get it off, and it doesn't sound good when you play with rosin on rosin, because it sounds quite scratchy and it doesn't make a nice sound. Well, these are the things you should really do daily. Then some other schedules: replacement of strings at least every year, because old strings, they don't sound good. So the tone is not good, but also the tone is not stable. So it wobbles a bit. So your intonation is out of the window, because your string makes a different tone every time you play on it. And that's because after a string gets used and get damaged, it doesn't vibrate regularly, and it becomes out of tune. So replacement of strings, and it depends on how much you play, what kind of strings you use, etc., how much you have to replace them. Probably if you're using the same strings for years, then you should really replace them, and it will surprise you how much good it will do to your instrument and your playing and intonation and sound. And for example, I replace my strings every 2 months. Sometimes I forget it, and then I'm using strings for 3 months, and then I have often that I hear a strange sound or strange intonation that I think, hey, why is this out of tune? And then I replace them, and then lots of things are solved. But maybe for you it's once a year, or maybe you will do even a bit longer with your strings, but really take a look at it. Well, the replacement of your rosin, yes, you need to replace your rosin once in a while too, because it gets really hard and the chemicals in the rosin don't work, and it becomes especially very very dusty, and it breaks fast, and it doesn't apply to the bow easily. Well, then once a year I recommend to thoroughly clean your violin and the wood of your bow. Don't forget the wood of your bow, because there's a lot of rosin in it, and if there's a lot of rosin on it, you can't easily clean it. And there are several brands of clean and care solutions. Use something specially for instruments. Don't use your own cleaning fluids on it. And then something you might not have heard of, and that is to soap the pegs of your violin. If the pegs of your violin turn a bit, don't turn smoothly, but they do fit. If they don't fit, you need to go to a luthier shop and have them replaced. But if they do fit, but they just, you hear a screeching sound when you turn them, then you need to use peg soap. Just take the peg out and soap it with peg soap to make them run smooth again. Then your bow needs to be rehaired at least once a year, they say, because the bow runs, the hair becomes too smooth at a certain moment, so it doesn't have grip on the string, and then it doesn't make it doesn't get to the sound, or doesn't make a good sound. So these are the things. Consider with rehairing your bow that rehair costs around 50 to 70 euros. So if you have a really cheap bow, you can better replace your bow than have a rehair. So this is the whole clean and care schedule. So every day is untighten your bow and wipe your violin and bow with dry cloth. Then for 1 year or longer or shorter, depending on how you play and how much you play, is replacement of your strings, replacement of your rosin, a good care of your violin and bow with some clean and care solution, the soaping of your pegs, a rehair of your bow, and of course once in a while check your whole instrument and bow if there are not any scratches or damages or whatever. Just keep that in mind, that you take good care of your bow and instruments. So I hope this is helpful for you. Thank you for watching Violin Lounge TV. If you have questions for me on violin or viola playing, just post them in the comments below. Or send me an email to info@violinlounge.com. Do you like this video? Then please click like. Do you want more violin top tips? Then go to violinlounge.com and you will find lots of useful information. I wish for you to express your unique beauty on a well-maintained violin. Happy playing! Bye bye! Join me in the free workshop Weight vs. Pressure, where I teach you to play the violin effortless with a beautiful tone. Go to www.violinlounge.com/free-workshop to get direct access to this workshop. I'm sure it will be worth it.